If your Android device keeps restarting or turning off, then let us see how to fix the issue. So the first thing that you can do is, if you are using a case for your phone, then remove the case. That case might be too tight, due to which it might be pressing the power button and the phone is restarting frequently. The other thing that you can do is, you have to check if there is an update available for your device. So go to settings, go to software update, go to download and install. The device will check if there is any update. Sometimes there might be a problem in the software due to which the phone is restarting, and this might be corrected by updating the software. For me, the software is up to date. If there is an update available for your device, update it. Now the other thing that you have to check is, you have to see how much of space is left in your device. You should have at least 10% of space free in your device for the applications to run properly. So go to settings, go to device care, go to storage. For me, I have 18.7 gigabyte left, but for you, if there is no space, then here you can check which item is taking more space. For example, for me, videos are taking 7 gigabyte. So what I can do is, I can go inside this one and then I can delete the videos and make space free in my device. Now the other thing what you have to do is, you have to check if this error is caused by any application in your device. So for that one, what you have to do is, you have to restart your device in safe mode. Now depending on the model of your Android device, it might be a different process, so you have to check. So once you have restarted your device in safe mode, then let the device remain in safe mode for a few hours and check if the error occurs or not. If the error does not occur, then it means it is caused by the application that you have installed. So if you can remember after which application you installed your device started to restart, if you can remember that one, then what you do, you uninstall that application and check if this will fix the issue. Or else you have to uninstall all the applications one by one and check which application is causing the issue. Now the other thing that you can do is, you can wipe out the cache partition. So for that one, what you have to do is, you have to press this power button, the volume up button and Bixby button at the same time. But before that, what you have to do is, you have to turn off your phone. So let me switch off my Android device. Power off. Once your device is completely off, then what you can do is, you have to start your device in recovery mode. For Samsung, what I have to do is, I have to press this power button, I have to press this volume up button and Bixby button, all of them at the same time. Now I have to hold it until I see the recovery mode. So once I see the recovery mode, I will leave it. So once the device starts in recovery mode, then there are a few menus here. It might not be clear, but there is one option here, wipe cache partition. So I can select that option by pressing the volume down button. So once I select this wipe cache partition option, then I can enable it by pressing this power button. So this will remove all the cache files. It will not delete any other document. So I will press this one. And then it is asking me whether I want to wipe out the cache partition. So I have to select this yes option by pressing the volume down button. And then I will select yes by pressing the power button. So once the cache partition is deleted, I have to reboot the system. So reboot system now is selected, I will press the power button. So once your system restarts, then wait for a few minutes to check if your Android device restarts again or not. The next thing that you can do is, you can disable the auto restart option if you have enabled in your Samsung device. So for that one, you will go to settings, you will go to device care, then you will tap on this more option. There is an option here, auto restart, enable it. And suppose if you have enabled this option, and if you have selected particular days, where your phone will restart automatically, then you can disable this option. Now the last option for you if nothing works is to factory reset your Android device. So this will delete all the things that are present in your device and it will go back to the factory state. But before that, remember to back up your device so that you will not lose your document. So once you have backed up, then what you do, you can go to settings, you can go to general management, reset, and then select factory data reset. So this will delete all data from your phone, including your Google account, system, app and data, settings, downloaded apps, music, etc. And also all the accounts that you have added will be deleted. So if you want to do the factory data reset, you have to select this option, reset. Now after doing all of these things also, still if your device is restarting automatically, then it might be a problem with the battery which is present inside the device. So if the device is really old, the battery might be damaged. So in that case, you have to change the battery. Thank you for watching this video. Please like and share this video if you found it helpful. Also click on the subscribe button and hit on the bell icon to get the notification of our latest videos for free.